In 1965, Charlotte College awarded its first bachelor's degrees to a graduating class of 20. Two of those graduates were engineering students Bill Roseman and Ray Young. By 2015, Charlotte College had become the University of North Carolina at Charlotte, and its William States Lee College of Engineering was graduating more than 600 students a year. For its first 50 years, the faculty and staff of the Lee College of Engineering were dedicated to a mission of providing students with the best applied, hands-on educational experience possible. It was this dedication that attracted Bob Snyder to UNC Charlotte in 1975. Snyder started as the chair of mechanical engineering and then became dean of the College of Engineering in 1977.
When I came here, I found such a great potential, nice people to work with, and a real commitment to good engineering education. And that's what I wanted. My philosophy about students had always been, I would be willing to let almost anybody into the College of Engineering, provided I was convinced that they wanted a degree. They really wanted to be an engineer.
Snyder led several initiatives during the 80s to develop and modernize the college's programs and facilities. These included an expansion of the Smith Building and the construction of the Cameron Applied Research Center.
The Cameron Center was a big step forward because that was the first research building on this campus. Well, as soon as we had that research center, then we had something to offer new professors.
A number of prominent researchers came to engineering in the fields of optics, microelectronics, precision engineering, and metrology. As their research programs grew, so too did engineering's graduate programs. Engineering success in research and academic programs was due to the dedication of its people and their close working relationships.
It was a family when I first came here. I mean, almost everybody knew everybody. I went home almost every day of my career feeling that I had made a positive impact on some student's life. I went home with satisfaction. I was a happy camper.
As the first home of the College of Engineering, the Smith Building kept all of the engineering disciplines close to one another, creating a sense of community that enhanced the philosophy of project-oriented, experiential learning.
When I was attending UNC Charlotte, there was one building that the College of Engineering was contained within, and that was the Smith Building. What was cool about that was that we had kind of a culture of entrepreneurship during that time period because everyone's crammed in the same building.
The culture of entrepreneurship created in the Smith Building had a profound impact on Kennedy's future, as he went on to form two companies in the field of solid-state power distribution. He also stayed involved with the college, including hiring a number of its students.
Most of the staff with both companies, both with Atom Power and Atom Engineering, are UNCC graduates or are getting ready to graduate. And the students that we found are ready to kind of put their hands on stuff based on what they've learned.
Throughout the 80s and 90s, the Lee College of Engineering continued to grow with new research centers and programs in biomedical engineering, motorsports, and environmental engineering. A student in environmental engineering, Bill Bovin, was impressed with the faculty's commitment to students.
After I was working on my bachelor's, what I found was the professors were very enthusiastic about teaching, but also the programs weren't set in stone. They were always adjusting and trying to do better. Here you can kind of focus more on a specific area if you want, even as towards the end of your bachelor's. Then once you get into your master's, there's a plethora of different areas you can go into. But what I found here within the College of Engineering is more of a family. As I've transitioned from bachelor's to master's to PhD, it's been actually more than I ever thought it would be.
Throughout the years, the closeness of the students was enhanced by the college's support programs. Senior Megan Kelly was involved in a number of these, including the Freshman Learning Community, the Leadership Academy, and numerous hands-on projects.
The The freshman learning community was a really great experience for me. You're surrounded by kids that are doing exactly the same kind of coursework as you, and we formed some really awesome bonds.
The bonds she's formed proved valuable when working on many team projects with her classmates.
I didn't originally expect it to be so team-oriented. We're all working towards the same thing, so it's great that we get to learn how to work together and help each other.
Bob Johnson became Dean of Engineering in 2000. To house existing disciplines and other new programs, including systems engineering, fire safety, computer engineering, and construction management, the college needed more space, and Johnson was involved in the planning and design of several new buildings.
So I've had the rare privilege of leading some design teams on buildings. Of course, the first was Duke Centennial Hall. Mechanical engineering was going to be home in that building, and a very carefully designed metrology lab. Then we added a motorsports lab next to it, separated from it, because there's noise. Race cars make a lot of noise.
With Duke Hall and the motorsports building in place to house existing programs, the college turned its attention to creating a new program and facility to support Charlotte's fast-growing energy engineering industry.
It was clear this industry was taking off in the Charlotte region, and it was obvious this was going to be really a big deal for the Charlotte community as well as the university.
UNC Charlotte won state support to create the Energy Production and Infrastructure Center, better known as EPIC. The 200,000 square foot EPIC building was constructed as the home of the new program and other academic departments.
Moving electrical and computer engineering in that building, and also civil and environmental engineering building, allowed us to build laboratories so we could better prepare the workforce in that entire industry.
The new buildings provided the space for the Lee College of Engineering to deliver its programs, but the key to success was always the people in those buildings.
So the heart of the college, when you get right down to it, is the faculty and the staff. It's a tremendous group of faculty and staff, work exceedingly hard, are very committed to the students. We have a great group of students. When they graduate, we get a lot of compliments on how hard our students work and how well prepared they are. Over 3,400 students today in engineering. As big as it is, we're a big program on a national scale. But there's still a strong focus on undergraduate education. So we really try to focus on very good application space for the students, very good training in that area, so they can hit the ground running in industry.
For 50 years, the William States Lee College of Engineering has delivered experiential learning that has prepared students for rewarding engineering careers. Through dedicated faculty and staff, the college has remained true to its mission of providing top-quality academic programs delivered through hands-on applied engineering education.